Hello and welcome! In the previous video, we added dynamic buffer support, which allowed us to differentiate between prefabs. Today, I want to show you how to implement a job correctly, as well as how to set components via entity command buffer, pass parameters, or query. You may ask, why use jobs in ECS code? First, you can use IJobEntity to iterate across component data when you have a data transformation that you want to use in multiply systems with different invocations. Second, to improve performance and delegate tasks to separate processor threads. Okay, so let's create public partial struct bullet movement job, which implements IJobEntity interface. Also create a private method void execute for now without parameters. In this method, we'll execute a piece of code. Depending on how we implement job, it will, for example, in our case, iterate over entity query elements. Depending on the problem, different approaches are possible. For example, you can pass native array to the job and call deallocateOnJobCompletion attribute, so it will automatically dispose native array after the job has finished. Okay, remove this line. Now let's add the code to the job that we ran earlier in the for loop. And of course, let's get rid of the loop here. This will cause some errors, but don't worry, we are going to fix them. In on update, let's create a job using the new operator. Let's open the curly braces, leave space for the parameters, and finally call schedule. Okay, so what is next? As you can see, SystemAPI is not accessible from job. This is problematic, but makes sense for ECS behavior. Fine. Let's pass the delta time parameter, and of course, we also need to add the delta time field to the job. To be able to set the local transfer component through job, you need to use entity command buffer, since state.entityManager is not available inside the job. You may ask, what is this? According to the documentation, an entity command buffer stores a queue of thread safe commands which you can add to and later playback. You can use an ECB to schedule structural changes from jobs and perform changes on the main thread after the job's complete. In other words, entity command buffer allows you to set, add or remove components from within jobs or create and destroy entities with the guarantee that they are thread safe. I think that structural changes also deserve a word of comment. Structural changes are operations that make Unity reorganize memory chunks or the contents of memory chunks. You can only execute them on the main thread and not from jobs, and they can require a lot of resources. The following operations are considered structural changes: creating or destroying an entity, adding or removing components, setting a shared component value. What is also important to know about the entity command buffer, it is recommended to use a different entity command buffer instance for every unique job. This is due to the possibility that if you reuse an entity command buffer in a series of jobs, the commands that the jobs record might be interleaved and the jobs might use an overlapping set of sort keys. For example, if both use ChunkIndexInQuery. Okay, let's go back to Writer and create best compile method private entity command buffer GetEntityCommandBuffer ref system state state. Now, according to the documentation, for automatic playback and disposal of entity command buffers, we should cache entity command buffer system singleton and create new command buffer. We want to execute the code at the end of the simulation group, so let's write ECB singleton equals get singleton and simulation EntityCommandBuffer System.Singleton. Of course, add required for update for this singleton. And return ECB singleton.createCommandBuffer with parameter state.WorldAndManage. With this approach, there is no need to manually playback and dispose of the entity command buffer. There are quite a few entity command buffer system groups available. I have included a link to the documentation in the description of the video. Okay, let's create public entity command buffer field in the job. And of course, pass ECB parameter to job in onUpdate. Now let's change state.entityManager.setComponentData to ECB.setComponent. And also fix delta time name. Okay, but what about the rest of the parameters? The solution might be a proper implementation of entity query in job. Let's remove all calls related to native array. And pass entity query to job in schedule. Now we want to be able to dynamically retrieve the necessary parameters of each query element. How to do it? The solution is, of course, simple. However, requiring excellent knowledge of ECS. We can pass the parameters of interest, namely entity, local transfer, and bullet aspect in the execute method. But keep in mind the keyword in or ref. In allows reading, while ref allows read-write access. In the case of aspect, we don't pass any keyword. And now let's take a look at our entity query build. It is missing the information that we will be passing the aspect. With this in mind, we need to add dot with aspect, bullet aspect, in the onCreate method. We could also remove dot with all bullet component data, we don't need it anymore. Let's check if everything is working in Unity. Great, you have implemented job. At the end, I want to show you a little bonus. Now, if we get ecb.asParallelWriter in our method, we'll be able to run ScheduleParallel and perform multi-threaded operation processing in job. Of course, fix the types for the ECB field to EntityCommandBuffer.ParallelWriter in the method and job. Also change public access to GetEntityCommandBuffer to private. In addition, we need to add an int EntityIndexInQuery with an attribute of the same name. This will allow us to retrieve a unique index, the index of the each element in the entity query, which is necessary for ECB.ParallelWriter to work correctly. So pass a new field as a sort key parameter to ecb.setComponent. Okay, let's see if the changes work in Unity. Hit play and... great! We implemented a job with multiply threads. Thanks for your time. I invite you to subscribe to the channel and support us on Patreon. See you soon in the next videos.